Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Gavin. When my wife and I were looking to buy a house, we found one with 120-year-old stained glass Tiffany & Company windows throughout. We love them so much and want more, but really can't afford them. So I began to make glass paintings. Today, I'm going to make a glass painting of Niagara Falls in honor of Regina Parmer, a 36-year-old nurse from Niagara Falls, New York, who was last seen leaving her work at Niagara Falls Memorial Medical Center on August 20th, 2002. According to news reports, Regina was a hard-working woman with a very loving and supportive family. When she didn't show up for work on August 21st, people immediately began to worry. A missing person report was filed on August 22nd. The police and the community were quick to respond to her disappearance. Police reported that as many as 200 volunteers from the community searched in and around Niagara Falls in the first couple of days of her disappearance. The only thing they found was her car, which was parked alongside the curb of the 200 block of Ferry Avenue in downtown Niagara Falls. This spot is within just a couple of blocks of the falls. There weren't any clues that were found on or in Regina's car that gave police an idea of where she might be. Stating that they had no evidence of foul play, police still feared that something nefarious had happened to her. A $1,000 reward was offered by family and friends to try to get information on her whereabouts. And by the following month, an additional reward of $2,000 was offered by the medical center where she worked and the employees' union. But for almost 3 months, nobody could find Regina Parmer. Then, on November 9th, 2002, Regina's badly decomposed body was found over an hour away near the entrance to Lakeside Beach State Park near the shores of Lake Ontario. Under similar circumstances, it might be reasonable to assume that Regina Parmer somehow had fallen over Niagara Falls and her body was washed up along Lake Ontario's shore. That happens occasionally, though bodies usually wash ashore closer to the falls in Lewiston or Youngstown. In this case, though, the evidence pointed to something more sinister. The condition of Regina's body was described as skeletal remains, covered in the clothing that she was last seen wearing. While she had only been missing for less than 3 months, most of her flesh had decomposed. Her body had been dumped into an overgrown area of private property near the entrance to the park and a small pavilion. She was discovered by a couple who had stopped to picnic. She was positively identified through dental records. Police declined to describe how Regina Parmer had died, only saying that she was a victim of a homicide. They added that they believed she had been dead since the time of her disappearance based on the decomposition of her body and the clothes she was wearing. It was later confirmed by police that she had died by strangulation, and that a garrot was found around her neck. By 2004, Regina's murder had yet to be solved. Niagara Falls Detective Captain John Solti said in an interview with the Buffalo News that while it was a difficult case, they were continuing to pursue leads. "In my opinion, it's a solvable crime," he said. Three years later, police still didn't know who killed Regina Parmer. A suspect's name came up before her body was found, then Detective Captain Ernest Palmer said. He was interviewed and released, but he was not cleared. Palmer repeated what his predecessor had said years before: "This is still a very solvable case." The next time Regina Parmer's name was mentioned in the news, it was 9 years later when the Niagara Falls Police Department created a special cold case unit. They were still working on finding out who killed her. The following year, Essie Parmer, Regina's mother, died without knowing what happened to her daughter. The last time I could find that Regina Parmer's name has been mentioned in the news was back in 2019, when police searched a home on the 1500 block of Pierce Avenue in Niagara Falls, New York. The investigation was reported to have been tied to an infamous cold case. Neither the police nor the other investigating agencies involved in the search said what they were looking for, but did release a statement that read, "Evidence collected will be examined and analyzed. We continue to have no comment until the results are obtained." Over the years, there have been a few different theories that have come up about who may have been responsible for the murder of Regina Parmer. The most popular one makes the claim that she was a victim of Artemio Sanchez, the infamous bike path rapist and bike path killer who terrorized the Buffalo, New York area for 3 decades. Personally, I'm not buying it. Sanchez had a type when he chose his victims. They were all white women. If he were the perpetrator, Regina would be his only African-American victim that I'm aware of. So I'm curious what you think. Do you have any ideas about who could have been responsible for Regina Parmer's murder? If you have any information, please contact the Niagara Falls Police Department at this number. And if you have any ideas that you want to throw around, please put them in the comments section below. Please respect people's privacy. I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's a departure from what I've done in the past. but it was an enjoyable experience to make this glass painting in memory of and in honor of Regina Parmer. Because we just passed the 19th anniversary of her death, my personal goal is to get this video to 1,900 views, which would be a lot for my humble little channel. Once this video gets there, I'm gonna give away the painting to one lucky subscriber. All you have to do to enter is subscribe to my channel, like the video, and leave a comment. Once this video reaches 1,900 views, I'll take all the comments, cut them into strips, and put them in a bowl, and then I'll choose a winner randomly. I'll then contact the name I choose through a reply to their comment, and they'll need to prove to me by screenshots that they liked the video and subscribed to my channel. All of the official rules to this giveaway are in the description of this video below. Of course, I am compliant with YouTube's guidelines when it comes to contests and giveaways, but if this is not legal in your state, this contest is void there. Now, if you're interested in buying a print or a jaclé of this glass painting, head on over to my website, gavinfish.com. And with that, I bid you adieu, and I hope to see you next time. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any comments or questions, please leave them below.